It looks like SpaceX just made a last-minute change to Starship's Flight 9. What happened? When is the new launch date? Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. As of May 8th, 2025, SpaceX is yet to officially announce a specific launch date for Starship Flight 9, but it appears likely to happen in mid to late May, with some sources suggesting May 19th, 2025, as a potential target. However, delays are possible due to technical issues, such as an explosion during a static fire test and ongoing Federal Aviation Administration, FAA, approvals. The road closure at Starbase on May 9th, 2025, indicates preparations are underway, but it's unclear if this directly aligns with the launch date. Flight 9 will use Booster 14, marking its first reuse, and Ship 35, both of which have undergone critical tests like cryogenic proof testing and static fires. These steps are essential for ensuring the vehicle's readiness, but the complexity of the system, with 33 Raptor engines on the booster and 6 on the ship, means any issues can push back the timeline. SpaceX aims for up to 25 launches in 2025, showing their ambition, but each launch requires careful regulatory and technical validation. SpaceX's Starship is a fully reusable spacecraft designed to carry crew and cargo to Earth, orbit the Moon, Mars, and beyond, comprising the Super Heavy booster and the Starship upper stage, both powered by Raptor engines using liquid methane and liquid oxygen. The program's iterative development approach has seen multiple test flights since its first integrated launch in April 2023, with 8 launches recorded by January 2025, achieving a 50% success rate with 4 successes and 4 failures. This history underscores the challenges of developing such an advanced, reusable system, with each flight building on lessons learned. Recent flights, such as Flight 7 in January 2025, have shown progress, notably with the successful catch of the Super Heavy booster by the launch tower's chopsticks, a key aspect of SpaceX's reusability strategy. However, the upper stage was lost due to a propellant leak, highlighting ongoing challenges in achieving reliable re-entry and landing for the Starship spacecraft. These tests are critical for refining the design and ensuring future missions can meet the demands of deep space exploration. The next planned launch, Starship Flight 9, is set to feature Booster 14 and Ship 35, with Booster 14 being the first Super Heavy booster to be reflown, a significant step toward proving full reusability. Recent updates indicate that Ship 35 has completed its cryogenic proof test, where it was filled with supercooled liquids to simulate launch conditions and a single-engine static fire, ensuring engine performance. Booster 14, having flown in Flight 7, will be equipped with 29 of its 33 Raptor engines being reused, aiming to reduce costs and increase launch frequency. Despite these preparations, the exact launch date for Flight 9 remains uncertain. As of early May 2025, SpaceX has not officially confirmed a specific date, though there have been indications of a mid to late May timeline. A road closure was scheduled for May 9th, 2025 at Starbase, Texas, typically preceding launches or major tests, suggesting imminent activity. However, ex-posts from early May, such as one on May 2nd, 2025, mentioning a delay due to an explosion during a static fire test, and another on May 6, 2025, suggesting a tentative date of May 19, 2025 at 2330 UTC, indicate uncertainty. I'd like to quickly remind you to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. We regularly upload informative SpaceX and space news videos that you won't want to miss. Be sure to turn on the notification bell so you're notified whenever we release new content. The FAA's involvement, requiring a license for each launch, adds another layer of complexity, with ongoing investigations potentially affecting the timeline. Flight 9 aims to build on previous achievements, with key objectives, including the first in-space burn of the Raptor engines on the upper stage, a maneuver demonstrated in a static fire test, but critical for actual flight conditions. Additionally, SpaceX is working to refine the re-entry profile, aiming for a successful landing or catch of the upper stage, a challenge not yet fully overcome. The vehicle's technical specifications are impressive. Standing at approximately 120 meters tall when stacked, it can carry up to 100 tons to low Earth orbit, or 150 tons to the Moon, when fully reusable, with a 9-meter diameter payload bay suitable for large satellites or crew habitats. Its heat shield, using a modern tile-based system, is designed to withstand re-entry speeds up to 27,000 kilometers per hour, showcasing its capability for interplanetary missions. Looking ahead, 2025 is poised to be a pivotal year for Starship, with SpaceX planning up to 25 launches from Starbase, as approved preliminarily by the FAA, alongside 50 tower catches, 25 for Super Heavy and 25 for Ship. This increase reflects confidence in the system's reliability and the goal to rapidly iterate and improve. A significant milestone expected this year is the demonstration of ship-to-ship propellant transfer, crucial for enabling deep space missions like those to Mars. By allowing fuel transfer between starships in orbit to extend range and payload capacity, NASA's involvement further underscores Starship's importance, having added it to their launch roster for the Artemis program's crewed lunar landings, with SpaceX developing a variant for lunar surface landings and returns. This collaboration highlights the growing role of public-private partnerships in space exploration, with potential applications extending to lunar logistics and deep space habitats. Despite the progress, challenges remain, including technical issues like the reported explosion during a static fire test, which could delay Flight 9. The complexity of Starship, with 33 Raptor engines on the booster and 6 on the ship, means even minor issues can have significant implications. Regulatory hurdles, such as FAA approvals, and environmental considerations, like impacts on local wildlife and sonic booms, must also be managed. SpaceX has implemented mitigation measures, such as a water deluge system, but these factors can extend timelines. Starship's reusability promises to revolutionize space travel economically, potentially reducing launch costs to around $2 million per flight, opening opportunities in satellite internet, space tourism, and asteroid mining. Compared to other launch vehicles like Falcon 9, 22.8 tons to low Earth orbit, or NASA's SLS, 95 tons, non-reusable, Starship's 100-ton capacity and reusability offer significant advantages. Public perception has been overwhelmingly positive, with live streams attracting millions and social media, particularly X, fostering discussions. The program's educational impact is notable, inspiring STEM interest and offering internships, while environmental considerations, like methane use, are being addressed through sustainable practices. In summary, while the launch date for Starship Flight 9 is not confirmed as of May 8, 2025, it seems likely to occur in mid to late May, with May 19, 2025, as a potential target, though delays due to technical and regulatory issues are possible. The preparations, including completed tests for Booster 14 and Ship 35, reflect progress, but the complexity and controversy around delays highlight the challenges. As SpaceX aims for 25 launches in 2025 and milestones like orbital refueling, Starship remains at the forefront of humanity's journey to become a multiplanetary species, with significant economic, societal, and exploratory implications. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.